So now that we have our project upgraded to Laravel 9, what I want to do is start working on the checkout system. So the first thing that we need to do is create a controller. Let's head into the text editor. So in here, we're going to open up a terminal, and then we are going to call it checkout controller. We're also going to make it resourceful so that we have access to all of the functions. Now that that's done, let's go ahead and create the route. So we'll just come down here. I'm going to copy this, paste it under here, call this checkout. And then our first route will be a get route. And the controller will be the new one that we just created. So checkout controller. I need to make sure to put brackets around that. And the function that we're going to use is index. So now we can just call this checkout index. Let's make sure to import this first. Okay, and now let's head into that controller. So the only thing that I want to do in here for right now is to display a page. So we'll return inertia render. And the page, we're going to have a checkout folder. And this page will just be index. Well, we don't need the view, but we do need the semicolon there. Let's make sure to import this. Now let's go ahead and create this page. So right in our pages folder, we can do checkout index.view. In here, I'm just going to put some templates and some script tags. We're not using composition. I'm only using view, and we'll fix that in a second. But what I want to do is I want to go ahead and paste in some code. This way you don't have to watch me design all of this. Let's move this over and then we'll go ahead and take a look at what it is. First, we have our app layout, and I've already done an episode on what the app layout is, so make sure to check that. By the way, I'm also leaving links for the playlist in the description and the comments down below as a pinned comment so that you guys can go and catch up if this is your first time with us. That being said, we have an app layout. The title for the page is checkout. We have a function here for process payment. It's basically going to be the form is going to be on the left side, and the order totals are going to be on the right side. So that's just pretty much what all of this is doing here. So let's scroll down. I've just commented out the states for now because we're going to do something different with that. And we just have something for code. For the rest of the form, the errors, the emails, the name on card, this is different stuff that we're going to be getting in from Stripe. So for now, I just have it saying pay now as the button, and we have our order totals component, and we do need to start bringing some of this stuff in. So instead of this, I'm going to need to do components. And just so I don't drive myself crazy trying to rethink all of this, the first component that we're going to need is the app layout. And we'll make sure to put it in our component section here too. The next one we will need is the order totals component. Need to add that down here as well. And then we also need the button, which in here it's going to be the yellow button. Again, I went over this part already, so just check the playlist for these episodes. So components, buttons, yellow button, and then come down here and add that as well. Something we're also going to need in here is the link. For the inertia link. I think it's inertia view 3, and then we'll put it at the top of these. Okay, and let's see just what exactly we've got going on here. We can now go to the checkout route. And I want to open the inspection tool so we can see our errors and our warnings. Okay, so this is from the form. What's this? This is from the form. Okay, well, let's start working on that. So we need the email, the name, all that good stuff. And also, we're not going to be using Inertia for this particular one because we are going to be using Stripe. We're going to be making Axios requests between our backend and Stripe. So we do need to have just a regular form here. It doesn't need to be Inertia. And then we need name, email, and also, excuse me for this, return. Now we can bring this up and stop getting those errors. Okay, so hopefully those should clear up some of those errors, but we might get some new ones, so let's check it out. Okay, property errors was accessed. Oh, because like I said, we are going to be making Axios requests, so we do need to have put it above form errors, and we're just going to leave this as an empty array. Okay, so now we're getting somewhere. Fantastic. Okay, so the first thing I want to do is going to be really simple. This project that I'm making is specifically just for the US because it's a demo. It's very basic. It's very sort of default. So I'm only going to be including states, but if you want to make this more international, then you can go ahead and obviously do that. I'm just showing you how I've been doing it. And what I want to do is I want to create a dropdown for these states. So how we're going to do that is we're going to create a JS file. And we just need to head right up to the top of this JS and create a new file. And I'm going to call it states.js. I'm just going to go ahead and paste this. And all this is a constant of states. And then it's just an array of states, basically. And then it's exported default. Okay, so let's go back to the index. And now we can bring that in. Okay, so now what we can do is we can loop over these states. So we already have a section for that, and that's what I commented out. So we can go ahead and uncomment it now. In this, we just have the label for state, and then we have a select section where our options are going to be the states that we're looping over. Okay, and the first option is just going to say, please select one. Let's make sure that that's coming in at least through view. Okay, so we have it here. And let's check view and make sure that that's coming in here as well, which obviously it is because we can see it on the front end, but it is in our view. Okay, and if we click it, we can select any of the states. Fantastic. So now the other thing that I want to do is I want to bring in this button. And I'm going to go ahead and uncomment that. And we've already brought it in, so everything is fine. The only thing we don't have is this spinner. All I need to do is to go to the icons file, and we'll just paste it right under here. And if you missed this episode, again, it's in the playlist. So let's go ahead and see what we have. Okay, so now we have our button, and we need to add some states onto this as well. If you take a look at the code, I have a disabled and I have a via floating, so we need to add those states down here. And here I'll just put disabled is true. This way, when the form is filled out, then the disabled will turn to false, and then we'll be able to click it. So that's just a little check for that button. This should have a disabled state on it. And it doesn't, and that's because disable, it should be disabled. Good to go. So now we can't even click it. Fantastic. What I want to do is I want to close this, and we have something in the cart. So that information should be in here. And if you caught the episode on service containers, you know that we have something that we can use for this. We go to our cart controller. We are rendering these out in the cart. We can just copy this. We already have the service container, so we're just going to do the same thing. First, I want to add cart service. And then I want to create a variable and I want to call it contents. Then that's going to equal an array. And then we're just going to paste in all of those values in here. Okay, the only thing that we do not need in here is the later count and the later items. Everything else we can keep. And instead of bringing all of these in, we can just say contents. As you can see, this saved us an immense amount of code. These service containers are really, really useful. I just want to pull all of these in to our props for this index page. And actually, we don't need cart items. And now we can bring these values into the component, which is the order totals component. And as I said, I already went over these, so I'm not going to go over them again. Equals, and then go ahead and paste them in. And this is what we're going to be passing in. Now, before we pass these in, I just want to make sure that these values are correct. So in the order totals component, I'm going to grab these so I can compare them. Okay, so tax rate is tax rate. We don't need cart items in here. Cart subtotal, this is just subtotal. Tax code discount is the same. New subtotal is just total. Let's go ahead and get rid of this. And now let's see if we're getting these values in that component. Okay, great. So we have a coupon in here and we have our subtotal. Let's try to see if this stuff works. So since we already have one in, I put one in before, I'm going to go ahead and try to get rid of it. So that functionality works. Fantastic. And now I can try. Okay. And so that is all working. And it's another thing that we've pulled out into a component. And now we have reusable code. We can use it pretty much anywhere. If you are enjoying the content, please go ahead and click that like button as it really does help out the channel. I'm going to leave links in the description, including the playlist, so that you can catch up on all of the videos in this Laravel e-commerce series. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.